Good morning, guys. Today I am getting ready to go to the Oregon Convention Center here in Portland, Oregon. I'm going to go to Wizard World Comic Con, and I'm really, really excited. I decided to dress as Kaylee from Firefly. She's one of my favorite characters on the show, and the actress that plays her, Jewel State, she's going to actually be at Comic Con today, and I have a photo op with her later. I'm so, so excited. I can't wait. The plan is to check out all the vendors. We're going to sit in on a couple panels. I really want to check out James Marster's panel and Jewel State's, so hopefully we can get in on those. I'm going to take pictures, so I'll have a photo slideshow. I'm going to try to do some time lapse if I have a moment to just sit down for a little bit and just check out all the sites. It's going to be so much fun. I'm going to take you guys with us, and hopefully you enjoy today as well. So I will see you guys there. Enjoy today's video.
Yeah. If anyone is dressed in costumes from any show that I've done, come to my table, and I'd like to put you on Facebook. And then, at the end of it, I would like for everyone to cheer for everyone who came to my table to come on Facebook. So that cheering is you guys, if you don't mind. You guys mind? Okay, so just like when I go one, two, when I go like that, that's Hollywood for action. And everybody raise your arms and cheer as loud as you want to, okay? Welcome to your own hometown. I love coming to Portland. Portland, if you guys don't know how lucky you are, you guys are so lucky to live here. It's like a whole town of musicians, which is high compliment. Musicians get a bad rap. Like, everyone thinks we're drug addicts and weirdos, but musicians in general are like you guys. Chill, well-read, and a little weird. Yeah. What I like to do is take questions from the audience, and you guys can ask me anything that you want. If you want to try to embarrass me, I dare you. I'm shameless. I don't necessarily promise to ask anything that you think of, but you can try.
I've been watching Angel and Buffy the last year, and I'm so surprised to find out how much of this generation is watching the show, and I just wanted to know how that experience is, and talking to the second generation that are watching it all, binge watching on, you know, Netflix or DVDs, what's that like?
I knew it. I was right. When we were filming Buffy, I was constantly telling people, I'm a Star Trek fan, and I know the cycle. If something is delightful enough, it can catch on and go multi-generation. And if we do it right now, today, guys, wake up, have a cup of coffee, because we could do it with this show.
Yeah.
I remember telling Sarah, like, you and I may go on to multi-million dollar contracts, who knows the future, but I don't think we'll ever touch the nerve of the world like we are right now today, sir. And she was like, shut up, James, I'm tired. Poor Sarah, they worked her to death. We were known as Buffy the Weekend Slayer around Hollywood because we worked 12 to 20 hours a day. And that, usually a television show works 12 hours and that's it because you have to pay the crew double after 12 hours. But Buffy just blew past that all the time. And Sarah was in almost every scene. And I wasn't, so I was like, I'm fine with this schedule. She was like, I'm tired. Yeah, but I kind of knew it. I was a Star Trek fan. And I always said, man, if we go Star Trek, I get Spock. Spock, Spike, Spike, Spock. Same thing.
Well, you guys have the internet, too, which it's amazing to me. There are Facebook groups, very active Facebook groups, still dedicated to arguing about, you know, who's better for Buffy, Angel, or Spike. And I go on as, like, the old muse, you know, like, well, I used to get the magazine, and I can tell you, you know, in the day. You know? And it's hilarious.
Well, what do you think? Who's better for Buffy?
Spike, for sure.
Love like that, you know, you can't be bad. They're not doing that, you know. So I kind of didn't worry about it, and I don't know how British. I was kind of doing what, you know, Roger Daltrey and Paul McCartney do when they sing pop or rock. Yeah, so I know it wasn't hard at all.
My request was going to be, would you sing us a little bit? But
sing a song?
Yes, please.
Okay. Okay, I'll sing this one. This one I usually sing because it's designed to be a cappella. This is not from Buffy, this one I wrote. This was written in, where was I? I was in Romania, and I was doing a cowboy picture about a cowboy that is gonna get married, but he goes off to the Indian Wars, and he tells his lover, I'll be back, and then he never comes back. And then later, he shows up and he's going to be hanged because he got caught robbing a bank, and he is at the end of his life, and his ex-fiance is there to watch the hanging, and I wrote a song about it called the Cowboy Song. Well, I'm alone.
What the? Canaveral with my lady by my side. After wars, I left her, and now she's come to watch me die. She's a flower in the sun. Now she's crawling through the mud. 'Cause of me, 'cause of me. My heart was sick from killing engines with their babies in their beds. I refuse, but my general put his gun up to my head. And I wanted to come home so Abby wouldn't live alone. So I killed, burned them down. I woke up, cold dark morning, saw a face in the mirror, realized what I was bringing home wasn't worth bringing anymore. So I tried to heal my sores with rum and whiskey and whores. Didn't work, I was still bad. Sheriff put the noose right around me, pulled it tightly, snapped my neck. You won't want my love, see me strangled when my soul's blown out to hell. So I'm alone in hell. See poor Abby cry one more time.
Sullivan Masters from Ghost of the Robot. Charlie DeMar from Ghost of the Robot. Are there any Firefly fans in the house? My name is Tony Kim. I write for a site called Crazy for Comic Con, and I'm super excited to be here with you. Yeah, it's going to be an awesome time. Welcome to Portland Comic Con. Remember, we want you to use social media, so anything you hear, see, breathe, taste, whatever, hashtag it out, Wizard World, or hashtag Con Life. All right, let's get right to it. So, you know, whether it's on The Killing, or on Stargate Atlantis, or on Firefly, our favorite grease monkey in the universe, please welcome to the stage, Jewel State!
Here today.
So we'll have to whisper for the rest of the panel.
If he didn't wake up during that, then we good.
I asked first if it was okay if we could yell, so I got the okay. But
yeah.
Well, welcome to Portland.
Thanks.
Yeah, how are you doing?
I'm good.
How is motherhood?
You know what? It's a lot more fun than I thought it would be. But I lucked out. I got a really good baby. Sleeps really well, and he's really sweet and calm and gentle, and he's like his dad. Joss got a hold of some people through casting, my agents, I guess, through casting, and asked me to put the role on tape, which I did. I was living in Vancouver at the time. I'm still living there now. The rest is history, I guess.
Was the role pretty well formed?
Yeah, it's Joss Whedon.
We're
puppets. That's what we do. Okay, we all got really lucky. We got in the right place at the right time. And he writes really great words for us to say. And they even tell you where to stand. It's crazy, guys. So easy.
In the wonderful run of the show, way too short. But out of those shows, is there a favorite show or moment that you'd love to share with our fans?
Well, my favorite episode is Out of Gas. I really like that one. And I always say that I think Janestown is highly underrated.
Not by this crowd.
Maybe not. But no one ever says that Janestown is their favorite episode. And if you watch it again, it's actually really funny. It's our funniest one, if you ask me.
We'll start with one of our first questions. Yes, go ahead.
Hey, Joe.
Hi.
So, if you worked in a record store and you caught me shoplifting a, let's say, Hootie and the Blowfish CD, how would you react? Come on, you don't get the reference?
You know, I get the reference.
Okay, nobody else does.
This is my first convention back this year. And I'm just like getting warmed up to these questions. You know what I mean? Like last year, at the end of the year, I was firing on all cylinders, and now I'm like, oh yeah, right, these questions. Keep me on my toes. I don't know, man.
It was a very different role for you, yes?
You're telling me. You guys know she's talking about Dead Like Me? Did you guys ever see Dead Like Me? It's a great show. Yeah, I played this moody goth girl. They put me in a black wig and, you know, black lipstick and the whole bit. And I got to bust this guy for shoplifting. And then I ended up having sex in a closet with one of the main characters on the show. And that was the first thing we shot, actually. It's me and Callum, and I was like, hi, nice to meet you. All right, here we go. That's my job. Like, that's what I get paid to do. It's really weird. A lot of good ones. It's hard for me to choose one. I really love that little moment in Out of Gas, at the end, when everybody comes back and Mal is in the hospital bed, and Kaylee says, you fixed the ship, good work. I really love that. I love that moment. But most of my favorite lines don't belong to me. Other people have said them. A lot of Nathan's stuff. I find his character is my favorite character on the show. He's such a rough, moody kind of man, but he's also so soft and sweet, and cares so much. So when he drops his guard and he says something vulnerable, it just really kills me. When he says, everybody dies alone, that's a beautiful moment. And he's obviously so crazy good in that part. Don't tell him I said that. Don't. Let's not feed the monster, okay? Okay, I love this guy. This is you guys, look. It's Drag Kaylee. Up before the question gets asked.
It's incredible. I'm glad I meet a lot of fans. Have there any been fan moments that have stuck out to you, good or bad?
One day, my friends, I will write a book.
We've loved your roles. We can't wait for the future. Thank you so much for being
Thanks,
here. Let's
guys,
go to Angel Snack!
Ready to get a photo up with Jules State. So excited, I'll insert the photo here.
Austin, you want to take a picture with me? I think your mom wants to take a picture. Come on.
Well, that's going to wrap up this year's Wizard World Portland Comic Con. I had so much fun. I enjoyed the panels and the photo op with Jewel. That was awesome. That was probably my highlight. Hopefully you enjoyed today's video. I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe for many more random life adventures. And stay tuned to the very end of this video. I will have a photo slideshow of all the pictures I took. All right, enjoy. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you again real soon. Bye.